Hi, it's Terry Vanover with Choosing to Rise, and I'm going live again here on a Wednesday evening, the day before Valentine's Day. So, my topic is going to be about love after divorce. So, we're going to be talking about knowing when you're ready to get back into that dating scene, when you're healthy enough to date. So, who am I? I'm Terry Vanover, and I'm a divorce strategist. I help women come through divorce without being legally, emotionally, and financially devastated. And I help them to uncover who they truly are so they can walk confidently into that next chapter of their lives. So if you want to join me every Wednesday evening, we talk about a topic that's going to help you heal, move forward, and get you back where you want to be. So, tonight's topic is are you healthy enough for dating? Are you ready to date? So there's some tips that I'm going to give you tonight so that you know whether you're ready to jump back in. And it doesn't have to be on Valentine's Day, of course. You can have a Galentine's Day or date yourself for a while. That's what I really suggest you do for a while, is date yourself. And what does that mean, date yourself? Like, that's such a cliche term, and yet people don't know what that means. When you say date yourself, do things that you would want a date to do for you. Treat yourself as if you want a date. You want to go out for a fancy dinner? Go date yourself. Go take yourself out for a fancy dinner, right? You want to see a movie? Go see a movie. Go do it, right? So that's what dating yourself means. So are you ready? Are you ready to date? How do you know? Well, you know when you kind of search your feelings, and if you have that nervous but excited, and you're kind of a little afraid, but you're curious too at the same time, that means you're ready, right? It's a good kind of a feeling. If you are frightened to the point when someone says dating and you want to throw up, like, that's not a good sign. That means, hey, you're not ready, you need to do some work. If it scares you and you look like a deer in a headlight when everyone mentions I'm going out on a date and don't talk about it around me, that's not a good sign. So you don't want to start dating when you're in that space. Okay. So then you need to think about questioning your fears. What is it about dating that has you fearful? Are you afraid that you'll be rejected? Are you afraid of commitment? Are you afraid of the actual, like, I'm older now, I'm not as young as I used to be, people won't find me attractive. So question those fears. Find out what's beneath those fears. Really search yourself, journal about it, figure it out, get some help on that, get some support on that, so that when you are dating, you're out there, you're confident, you feel good about yourself, you're not questioning what's going on or why you're fearful, right? It's a good nervousness, should be a good thing. And then the next part is, this actually came up at our support group meeting over the weekend, and I actually had said, be yourself on a date. And someone, one of the women, shouted out, I don't know who that is. And I was like taken aback. And so I thought, I shouldn't have said be yourself. I should say know yourself. You need to know who you are. If you don't know who you are, you definitely should not be out there dating. That was a really powerful moment because I think a lot of people lose themselves. They lose themselves in their marriage. They lose their identity. They become maybe what they don't want to be. They lose their hobbies. They lose what their interests are. Some people that are in toxic marriages really, really lose who they are. And maybe they lose their sense of identity. They've been a wife for 30 years and they don't know what to be after that. So the important thing is to know yourself before getting back into the dating scene, because you got to know who you are so that you're making sure that you are attracting the right healthy person. Because what I see over and over and over again is people who repeat the same patterns over and over and over, and they attract the wrong person, or they're attracted to the wrong people who are going to mistreat them. And so they keep repeating this cycle of bad relationships because they don't take the time to know who they are and to heal themselves. So That's why the second marriage rate is 60, the divorce rate, second marriage divorce rate is 67%. So twice the range of a first divorce, because people just repeat the pattern. They think it's the partner, but what it is, it's you are making the same mistake over and over and over. And if I bet you search your past relationships and you look at the boyfriend before your husband and the boyfriend before that, you'll start to recognize some patterns of what you did in those relationships. And you'll see, the common denominator in this is me. I'm the one making these choices. I'm attracting these people who are using me or who are not recognizing my value because I don't recognize my value. So I choose people who mistreat me and take advantage of me. And you know, so I want to help you through this, right? It's so lonely when you keep choosing the wrong partners over and over and over, and you know that there's a pattern, but you don't know how to break that pattern. And it's so lonely. And I don't want to see people in that 67 percentile. And I don't want to see you dating the ex over and over and over. And here is something else that was really, really potent at the meeting that we had last week. And it was actually my realization that I came to was that I'm a mom and I have daughters, especially. And I realized as I was telling my story to the group, I am my mother's daughter. I repeated her sins almost to the year, like her divorce, everything. I mean, it was like a light bulb moment went off for me that, wow, if we don't break these patterns, not only do we repeat them, but we pass them on to our children and our children repeat them. And it just goes on and on and on. And they think this is what a marriage looks like, or this is how they think their mom should behave. It doesn't value herself, or, you know, goes out with men who don't treat her well. So it can be really, really destructive, and we can pass on these destructive patterns to our children. So it's so vital that we learn how to heal ourselves and overcome, you know, because some of us like will choose bad relationships because we're just afraid of being lonely. We don't want to be alone. I had that issue. I didn't want to be alone. So I did a lot of things that out of the fear of being alone. So, you know, I want to help you through this. I want to help you heal yourself so that you're not passing on these patterns to your children. You're not living in a fear of loneliness and being with partners who don't treat you well over and over, and find the marriage that you really, really want. So, you know, I have a complimentary phone session for the first three people that reach out to me. You can join me on, find me on Facebook Messenger. I have a complimentary phone session. It's my three steps for healing yourself so you can find the love of your life. So give it to yourself as a gift for Valentine's Day, right? You know, let's talk, let's find out what's going on and find out how to heal yourself so that you can find the love that you deserve so that you don't have to go through another Valentine's Day alone. So find me on Facebook Messenger, or you can always find me at TerryVanover@comcast.net. And I'd love to chat with you. All right, I'll see you next Wednesday live. We'll talk about another topic and help you move forward. All right, see you later.